You can begin now.
Sure. A very good afternoon to one and all present here. Today, I, Pragati Chaudhary, on behalf of Geeta Ratan International Business School, welcome you all to the session of Impact Lecture Series 2 on Patent Application Process, Leveraging Its Benefit for the Innovators of India. Geeta Ratan International Business School was established in the year 2004. GIBS is affiliated to Guru Gobind Singh Indraprastha University, Delhi, and is approved by All India Council for Technical Education, Ministry of HRD, Government of India for Technical Programs, and Bar Council of India for Law Programs. GIBS is currently offering postgraduate programs, which are MBA, MBA International Business, and undergraduate programs, which are BBA LLB, BA LLB, and BBA. GIBS has been graded A by National Assessment and Accreditation Council in second cycle. It is an ISO 9001:2015 certified institute. GIBS has been rated A+ by State Fee Regulatory Committee, a fee committee of Government of NCT of Delhi, and rated highest grading A by Joint Inspection Committee of Government of NCT of Delhi and GGSIIT University. GIBS has been rated grade A by Academic Audit Cell of GGSIIT University consecutively for past 8 years. Also, GIBS has been rated number 2 by Times Way School Survey consecutively for last 3 years. High quality patents are particularly important for startups. They represent valuable assets that can attract investors and enable business partnership. A patent is an exclusive right granted for an invention, which is a product or a process that provides, in general, a new way of doing something or offers a new technical solution to a problem. To get a patent, technical information about the invention must be disclosed to the public in a patent application. As per the Patent Act 2005, the inventor or his agent, assignee, or his legal representative, or his heir can apply for the patent in the head office of the Patent Office of India. The Indian Patent Office has its branches in various states. The Patents Act is the central legislation that deals with the filing and regulation of the patent application in India. Patent application can be filed with the local branch of the Indian Patent Office or at headquarters, depending upon the location of the applicant. Patent filing process is the most important work for the protection of intellectual capital of an enterprise. Under the Copyright Act 1957, the term word includes all artistic work comprises of a painting, a sculpture, a drawing, an engraving, a photograph, a work of architecture or artistic craftsmanship, dramatic work, literary work, musical work, sound recording, and cinematography. Copyrights are other ways of protecting the intellectual capital. The Impact Lecture Series is an attempt by Ministry of Education, IIC, to proliferate the cause of entrepreneurship. GIBS IIC is proud recipient of Impact Lecture mandate in the same pursuance this webinar is organized on the theme of patent application process, leveraging its benefit for the innovators of India. The major objective of the series are to create awareness on the patent filing process and related nuisance for the budding entrepreneurs and students, to develop an understanding among students on the Copyright Act and procedures for applying the copyrights, to make students understand relevance of IPRs. Our speaker for the day is Dr. Amit Kumar, Professor and Head at Acropolis Institute of Technology and Research, Indore. Sir possesses strong educational background with graduation in mechanical engineering, PhD philosophy in area of supply chain management from SGSITS, Indore. Sir holds expertise in teaching of core subjects like entrepreneurship, education, industrial engineering, operation management, patenting, innovation, and research. Sir has served as a professor in the Department of Mechanical Engineering at Mahakal Institute of Technology, Ujjain. There, he has worked as a professor in charge for All India Council of Technical Education, New Delhi, and Rajiv Gandhi Technical University, Bhopal. Sir played a key role in communication with AICTE and university related to guidelines, procedures, grievances, and ordinance related to matters. Dr. Amit has worked as examination superintendent for university examinations. Also, he has organized various seminars and workshops and is active member of various committees. Dr. Amit is a chief coordinator of innovation and entrepreneurship development cell of the institute. He also has worked closely with EDII and NEN for entrepreneurship related activities and events. Sir holds 2 patents in his credit and is a co-founder and director of a startup. Welcome, sir. We are glad to have you with us and eager to hear and learn from you. Over to you, sir.
Thank you. Thank you so much, Ms. Pragati. Thank you, GIVS New Delhi. Special thanks to Dr. Sheetal ma'am for having me here. A very good morning, good afternoon to all of you. And let me start with the comment that I'm not a patent attorney. Okay. So what I will be going through is the common man understanding of patent filing. So please allow me to share my screen. Ms. Pragati, please confirm that, is it visible?
Yes, sir, it is. It is visible.
Fine. Thank you so much. So once again, a warm welcome to this Impact Lecture Series on the topic patent application process and how you can leverage it for the innovators. And I am deeply pleased to have this session. When coordination with Dr. Sheetal happened, so I could not just deny. So thank you so much again. Now, if you see what actually will be the agenda. So as I told, I'm not a patent attorney or a patent agent, but since I had gone through the process several times, so I will explain in nutshell what actually is patenting process. But before I do that, because there is another session on copyright in the second half, so I will be restricting myself to patent. So the agenda would be the introduction. What do you mean by patent? General idea. Then the main part, the patent application process. Then why patent? Because ultimately we need to leverage it for the benefits. And how, small discussion on IPR and innovation, followed by Q&A session as an open forum. Now, when it comes to patent or copyright or trademark or industry design, they all come under intellectual property. So when we talk about intellectual property, it is nothing, it's a property. Just like other properties, assets, it's also an intellectual property. By the word itself, it refers to creations of the mind. Whatever human mind can create, it has that property. So that becomes the property actually. So it comes to invention, some literary works to be copyrighted, then some artistic works, designs, symbols. So the protection is very important. When we say IP, that is intellectual property, at the same time, its protection is very much important. That is why we use the term IPR. And I believe that the Institute GIVS is also having IP policy at place, because at one end you have to have innovations, then patents, and then on the other hand, you need to protect it. So there lies the term IPR. So when it comes to protection, so IP, intellectual property, is protected in law by various different terms like patents, copyrights, and which is ultimately having some purpose. One would be to gain recognition, or you can have a commercial aspect also. The aim of this IP system is actually to foster the environment of creativity. And we want that innovation should be recognized, it should be given some monetary value, and the entire ecosystem should flourish as a country. And for India, we have this ipindia.gov.in. To all my dear participants there, audience, the idea would be just go through this website. Spend 10 to 15 minutes and my purpose will be done. So for us, ipindia.gov.in is an exhaustive website which will explain everything about different IPs. Now, the intellectual property India, it is under Department of Promotion of Industry and Internal Trade. We call it DPIIT. So, which comes under Ministry of Commerce and Industry, Government of India. So, one should know that to which category we are working, for which category, under which government department we are actually coming when we go for any IPR. So, it comes under Ministry of Commerce and Industry broadly, but DPIIT is the main body, and the Office of the Controller General of Patents, Designs and Trademarks is the governing, main governing body. Now, just to give you an idea, the Patent Office, Design Office, Trademarks Registry Office, there are some Geographical Indications Registry Office, Copyright Registry Office. So as of now, these are situated at different locations. When I applied for patent, first I applied for at Kolkata, second at Mumbai. So there are different offices. So if you see this second column, Patent Office, you'll find at Kolkata, Delhi, Chennai and Mumbai. The Design Office is only at Kolkata. So these are some general things which you should know. And this entire organization wise, it's governed by CG, which is the Controller General, right? So this is the overall picture of what actually is IP, IPR. Now coming basically to all the intellectual property. So broadly we can categorize as patent, obviously, then copyright, industrial designs, layout designs, okay, then trade secret and trademarks. And what is the purpose is you need to protect, you need to invent, you need to license, cross license. There has to be some secret, there has to be some law, there has to be some industrial application, all said and done. So these all things constitute the intellectual property. My property, your property, anybody's property. So in India, specifically talking for our country, motherland, patents is governed by the Patent Act 1970, which was amended till 2005. Then the Design Act 2000. Trademark Act, Copyright Acts, like that. And at the last, you can see that even the plant varieties are also to be protected. Okay. So this is for all the legislation covering IPR in India. For our topic today, in the first session, patent. What do you mean by patent? So patent can be defined simply as a exclusive right. Once we transfer a house, we give all the rights to the buyer, right? Similarly, it's a grant of exclusive rights for a particular invention for a limited period of time. So we will clarify this term more clear and clear in coming sessions and slides. The protection is actually the patent owner. There can be two type of categories here. One is the inventor and another is applicant. A person can be inventor as well as applicant, or suppose you are working in GIBS. So you can be an inventor, but your institute can apply. So the institute GIBS can be an applicant. So applicant and inventor can be same or they may be different. And you can have number of inventors and number of applicants, right? So the patent provides the patent owner the right to decide, because it has got now the exclusive right, how or when that invention can be used by others, right? How anybody else other than the inventors or applicants can use or make use of that particular invention, okay? Now, basically it's right to exclude, because once you are having a patent on your name, basically you are excluding all others from its usage. So you can see from making, using, selling, importing, or offering for sale, you are excluding others. So that gives you a cutting edge or maybe commercial aspect. A typical example could be real estate. You purchase a piece of land, you construct some house, then you can sell it on to any other guy, and you transfer all the rights, including the taxes, house tax, property tax, everything. So, but once the registry is on your name, it's your property. That's a physical property. This is a intellectual property, right? Now, this is very important for especially the students out there, undergraduate or postgraduate students. The patentable subject matter in India, the invention for which you are filing a patent, can either be related to a process or a product or both. Either you are developing a prototype, which is a product, or something is there, the process inside you have invented, especially for pharma industries, chemical industries, the typical process under pressure, volume, temperature or conditions, or it can be both. And definitely it has to be new. We say novel idea, then it should involve an inventive step. Don't worry, I will take it you through the details of some of this. And normally it should be capable of industrial application. See, it doesn't make any sense that you invent something which is of no use. Obviously, it may be under your CV as a patent, but if it's not usable, either you give rights or not, it has to have an industrial application. That's very important. And it should not fall under section 3 and 4. I will explain what are those two sections. Okay. And for patentability requirements, again, categorizing the first para, newness, then inventive step, which is to say non-obviousness. Okay, it should not be obvious. It has to be non-obvious. Then capable of industrial application. Then how you enable it, transfer it to others. So all those requirements will give you or grant your patent. Okay, let us go into some details. Newness. If it is my class, suppose it could have been my class, I could have explained, discussed more clearly. But in the present scenario, present context of this online session, please allow me to go through the slides. And at the end, we will have an open discussion. There are some sections. So section 2, 1, I and J, they highlight the difference between new invention and invention. Now, when we say new invention, novelty or newness, so it can be any invention or a technology which was not anticipated by anyone anywhere else in the country or the world. Okay, and as you can see, it should not be in the public domain. Some newspaper article or something which is already existing somewhere in a down inside a village, but somewhere documented, so you cannot file a patent. Okay, because there is something called prior art. So prior art is which is anything which is known to public. So your invention should not be a part of prior art, right? So second is inventive step. I have filled the entire slide just to give you the text, the summary of what is the patent and what is patenting process. So please excuse me for filling the entire slide, but I will just pass it on to Sheetal ma'am for future reference. So basically, inventive step means that whatever you are doing little bit, it should technically advance the existing knowledge. Okay, you are at step two of some technology, or we say TRL, technology readiness level, and you are doing something which will scale it up. So there has to be some technical advance. Okay, so that means the non-obviousness. And when we say any person who is average skilled or a person skilled in the art should not do it. Okay, for example, there is a pottery making guy and another pottery making guy in village or some town or city is already doing some pottery making. So you cannot claim on that pottery making unless until you do significantly good when it comes to strength, design, material, mixture. Okay, so a person is skilled in the art is an average person. He should not be doing that thing what for which you are claiming an invention or a patent. So that means non-obviousness. Okay, so two points here. It should give technical increment to the existing knowledge, and second, that particular thing should be non-obvious to the person skilled in the art. That means average person skilled in particular art in the domain, right? Now, quite obvious, anything you can conceive, some hypothetical thing, some fantasy, it cannot be patented, obviously. So it means it is capable to be either made or used in an industry, which is also called usefulness. Okay. So you are patenting something, but it is vague, abstract thing, which is not done. It's not possible. So industrial application or utility, it is also one of the patentability requirement, right? Now, what is patentable? What are the patentability requirements? Those are one side. What is not patentable? So one should know. So there are some patents which fall under the scope of Section 3. So let us not go into much details, but Section 3, it bars you from filing patents under some categories. And there is another section, subsection, any invention related to atomic energy is not patentable. Never dare to go into that domain where you are doing something for nuclear energy, atomic energy. So those are not patentable. Okay. Now, who can apply? So as I said, you can be the true and first inventor, or you had invented your lab and with some professor, mentor or your college, you have assigned them, which is called applicant. So you can be first inventor or as well as true inventor, or you can be the assignee, okay, which is called applicant. Or in another category, you can be the legal representative of the some person who is no more now. For example, if you take example of Kishore Kumar, so there are many copyrighted songs. So those have been passed to his next generation. So you should be the first inventor's legal representative, right? So after the inventor is no more, the patent is transferred to the assignee, okay, or the legal representative, or you can say the further down the line in the family tree. So you can apply. Okay. Now, what is not patentable? Obviously, any invention which is contrary to some established natural laws, anti-gravity things and some, okay, bizarre things. So you cannot patent those things. And obviously, looking into public domain, anything which is harming public in general, or the morality issues are there, or you are damaging seriously human, plant or animal life, those things are not patentable. And you cannot have the discovery. Many a times I take a session on difference between discovery and invention, difference between invention and innovation. So those are small things. So any discovery is not patentable. Okay. Similarly, if some known substance is already present in Mother Earth and you just discovered, so those things are not patented. Iron, nickel, those are not, never, they had never been patented. Or some mixing, composition, compound, egg mixtures are not patentable. Obviously, then some arrangement, rearrangement or duplication. Okay, you want blue color, you are having green color, you mix them and you apply for patent. So those are not patentable, right? So some simple things. Now, in India, any method of agriculture or horticulture, the method is not patentable. And the treatment given to human beings and animals, okay, when a doctor performs surgery or some diagnosis or administer some medicines, so that process of treatment is not patentable. Any plant or animal, again, if you are having a typical animal, okay, some hybrid, you cannot patent. And this is point J. A mathematical method or a computer program in general is not patentable. So all those computer science guys, they should be very clear about what is to be patentable. Okay, fine. And the last thing is, any presentation, for example, I am presenting this slide, so I cannot patent it. Okay, I can go for copyright. And you can see at the bottom right, in front of my name, I have marked C, because this thing which I had compiled, it's copyrighted by me for this present topic. But the presentation of information, you cannot go for patenting, because it's a simply compilation or presentation summary of information. Then any mental act or game, like you are playing carom, you are playing cards, so any typical method cannot be patented. And in India, again, literally dramatic musical work, artistic work, those are not to be patented. And traditional knowledge, government is doing wonderful things when it comes to regaining the traditional knowledge. So any traditional knowledge, if you duplicate or aggregate it, combine it, then it is not patentable, right? So there is a whole bunch of thing for which you cannot claim patent, right? Now there are two basic limitations for a patent. First of all, you cannot have a patent for a lifetime, okay? Especially patent, keep in mind, I'm not talking about copyright or other things. So patent is valid for 15 to 20 years from the award date. In most of the countries, in India, will have 20 years. And again, it is limited by space, because if you file patent in India, it is under the Indian jurisdiction, Indian geographical boundary. If you file in US, so wherever you are filing, in that country only it is applicable, right? So that's why for good patents or very commercially high patents, people go for filing in other countries as well. For example, that electronic circuits, some chips, some innovations related to mobile, so they file patent across the globe. It's a costly affair, but it depends on which thing you are patenting. So there are two limitations: time limitation and space limitation. Now, the crux of today's topic is patent application process. Okay. As you can see, everything starts from mind, because ultimately, intellectual property is what? Anything which is the creation of mind. So first of all, you have to have one idea. And that idea has to be properly incubated, converted into something or a product or a process, then only you can go for filing a patent. Okay, you cannot write something 2 pages, half paragraph, and you go for filing a patent. So the very, very important step is idea incubation, followed by the entire process, right? So we'll go one by one. So here lies the entire process of filing patent in front of your eyes. Step one would be to have the idea. Not only idea, you have incubated that idea for some period, maybe 6 months, maybe 4 months. If it is highly technical, 1 year, 2 years, you keep on working on that idea. You tested at POC level, proof of concept, then maybe some prototype. Okay, then technology readiness level is there. Then you think that now I should go for patent. So that stage is very important. Okay, so all of a sudden you cannot file a patent. Then you go for an optional step of searching for the patentability. At times, what happens? I in this room, in this city, might be thinking of something else. Similar thing is applicable to you also. But maybe some other person in some other country or the same country might be doing on that same project. So it's like first come, first serve. If he has filed, she has filed first, then your case is gone. So it's always advisable to go for patentability search. Then you draft the patent, then you file the patent, the application is, patent application is published, then there is a request for examination, then there is request to objections, then for which you need to respond, and then ultimately you will have the patent granted. So I would like to emphasize on three terms here: patent applying application, patent publication, and then patent grant. These are all different things. So let us go one by one. When we talk about idea incubation phase, the very first step. So the first step is basically the beginning. What's my point? You have to have some idea, something at place, which will mark the beginning of your patent. So what happens? You capture, you work upon your idea very clearly. You should have the clarity of all the elements. And then ultimately you go for that confidence that, oh, now this can be patented. You can have your mentors, your teachers, you can have some external mentors, you can have patent agents, some agencies working in this field, and you may include drawings, diagrams to illustrate what your invention is. And word of caution, never ever disclose completely. And no Facebook, no WhatsApp. Even if you are working with your close friend, there should be a thumb rule. It should not be circulated in any social media. I repeat, the idea on which you are working should not be circulated on any social media, because once it comes into public domain, your chances of getting a patent can be lowered, or maybe totally the chances are gone. So I can confidently say this to all young students out there. Very good, you are working on some idea, but please resist yourself and rather restrict yourself in sharing, because that is the dangerous step. And it happens. Once we have an idea, we are very excited. We share. So you do share with your mentors, your close friends, maybe the inventors group, but it should not be in the public domain. Because once you have sent it to someone out of curiosity, excitement, it can go anywhere. So be very clear about your drawing, sketches, even some written thing. It should not go into public, right? Then once you have an idea, you should have the technical details. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4. These are my technical details, which will give you more confidence related to the product itself, the idea itself, and whether it can be patented or not. So it's a very, very critical step, right? Similarly, you can ask some questions. Okay, what is my idea actually? You can ask this to your friend, you can ask to that mentor, and how it is working, any problem it is solving or not, which field I am targeting. Okay, it is related to robotics or some sensors, IoT, or maybe related to biomechanics or some core chemical thing. Okay. So if these questions you can list down in your personal diary and you try to answer, then definitely you will get a clue about whether that invention is having usability or not, and ultimately whether you can file patent or not. Okay, if you can see, if you can yourself think that what are the advantages of my invention, okay, for that you need to compare with the existing knowledge or the prior art. So once you are working, questioning yourself, your own idea, then further steps will follow, right? Similarly, to give more cutting edge to your patent filing process, after cross-examining yourselves, you can go for a patentability search. Okay, and obviously, as I said earlier, I've shown also the novelty part, the non-obviousness part, and the usability part will be checked. So there are some patent agents, some good patent attorneys with whom you can work, you can take their help, or you can do yourself. Okay, so then you can have the mentors also who can give you opinion about whether it's patentable or not. Professional will help definitely. And based on the results, you can have the search report. Once I filed a patent earlier, my first patent, so then there was a search report. Okay, this was found. Just like if you publish a paper, there is a plagiarism check. It will give you number of percentage in numbers. Okay, how much is having some duplicacy somewhere. Similarly, the patentability search report will give you the opinion. Yes, positive, negative, it's already existing, or the similar thing is was just filed 2 months before or just 1 week before. So it can be negative or neutral. Neutral means you can still have some modifications possible with which you can raise your chances of filing for patent. Okay. At this stage, though this stage is optional, as I have written, but this gives you an idea whether you can go forward or not. Okay. Negative means gone. Positive, that means you should move forward. Neutral means again you go back to first step, again rejig and try to come up with the search report again, right? Now, this is very critical step. Just like once you go for a registry, you go for some stamp paper, some bond, some indemnity bond. So the language is legal. And normally, normal human tendency is to avoid such kind of technical terms, jargons or something. So the patent drafting process is also like that. So normally we go for some patent attorney or some patent agent, because drafting is not everyone's cup of tea. So patent drafting here means you are filing a patent. That means you are filling some application. Okay. So after your idea is incubated, you cross-examined yourself, then you went for search, patentability search. Now it's the right time, if the things are positive, to draft your patent. And believe me, your invention or idea is on one side and the drafting might be totally different. When I say different, that doesn't mean that it's not related to this, but the language is typical. And definitely it will require some special skills, and not everyone can file patent application on his or her own, because it's a techno-legal document. So normally we take help of professionals, okay, and they charge nominal fee. And you must be knowing government has also reduced the fee, government fee for filing a patent, which I will explain also. And while filing a patent, there are a number of sections, subsections, and so many rules are there. So you have to be very, very careful while drafting. You know what happens? Your patent or your invention can be patentable, but a poor drafting can damage it. So it has to be taken with proper care. Another step is that a patent attorney or examiner or agent, he or she writes in such a way that not only you are filing, but at later stage, when you will be called for examination, then later on when you will be licensing it to somebody else, if it is granted, then that commercialization phase is also to be taken care of now. Okay, so it's not like first application, then second application you can modify. Your patent drafting, very first draft, should cover that thing. That means you should have a broad vision of the next two stages also, right? So that's why patent drafting is very important. So next is filing the application. You have drafted in a techno-legal arrangement, okay? Then you are now going to file. Now filing is what? There are portals available, but you can go for physical mode also. So once you draft a patent, okay, it has to be filed in one of the patent office. I had mentioned Kolkata, Mumbai, Delhi. So based on your location or where your patent attorney is having the connections or whether he is operating. So you file something called provisional patent application. Okay, it's called provisional. Okay. And at times you can go for a complete patent if you are so much confident. And if you are given full positive remarks on searchability report, then you can file complete patent application. Okay. But if you are not that much sure, you can go step by step. Okay. And as discussed earlier, if you are filing patent in India, the protection is only in India. Okay. So that means the patents are territorial in nature. That is a limitation. Okay. But if you want to file patent in multiple countries, you can file. Okay, so then you need to tell your patent attorney that, okay, this is the patent and I want to file across the globe. So it can be also done. Now, it is recommended to file provisional patent application. Why? Because initially you should not give the entire cost, or if there are some chances later on, so that upfront cost will be saved. Because the patenting process will take its own sweet time. I will explain. But once you are paying upfront, maybe it may be a loss. So to avoid upfront cost, you can go for provisional. And the benefit is, okay, there are two guys, okay, one me and one some other fellow. If he or she goes earlier and file a patent, okay, suppose same invention, then the first, what we say FIR, in police station we go for FIR, first investigation report, first information report. So here also, you can get the benefit of filing a patent. It will be called as status patent pending, but you have got the right. Okay, this is called priority date or the application filing date, filing date, like that. Okay, and once you file for provisional application, you will get some more time so that your invention can be further taken forward. Okay, and if any correction, mistakes are there, you can again, okay, do some changes, and again you can apply for some revision. So most of the cases we go for provisional patent application, right? Again, in hurry or maybe in excitement, we may go for full application, but whether it's having some commerciality or not, okay, how much potential it is having for commercially viable. So you will be given some time to check, okay, and how some other businesses are willing to take the license from you. Okay. You can have some more time for market research and some more testing on the commercial product. Okay. So basically what happens, once you file a this patent provisional, you will get around 1 month, 1 year times. Okay, 1 year's time to go for some more corrections and to retest further. So that's why it is always advisable to go for a provisional patent, right? Similarly, at times it may happen that if the invention is not worth much commercially, you may abandon the patent. So in case of provisional application, you can abandon it. Okay, and if there are no takers of your invention, suppose, then also you can abandon. So that's why there are advantages, other than money, then some changes, some market study, more corrections. So a 1 year period is given to you for such things. And still you have the authority of that patent because the priority date is set, right? Now, what are the contents of provisional specification? Obviously the title. Once you file a patent, it will ask the first thing, title of invention, then some specification we call description, and the description contains the background, the field, okay, the statement, some claims. You claim that this will do that, this will do that. So that's why the need of attorneys sometimes felt, most of the times rather. Okay. Now, see now, once you file a provisional patent, it was patent pending. Now after 12 months, it can be patent granted. Okay. Only on one condition, that it is not rejected. Okay. Fine. So it's always better to go for a provisional application because automatically after maturing, it will be granted status and your exclusiveness will be retained, right? And once you had granted, given example, let us take an example. On 1st January 2021, I filed the patent provisional. When it will be granted to me? December 31st, or let us say 1st Jan 2022. But the priority date will be 2021. So even if the patent is granted after 1 year, you will be given the benefit of early priority date. That means the date on which you have filed provisional patent. So this is basically what happens. Especially my dear students, don't rush for ideas, but once you are clear, immediately file the provisional patent. Then you can do some more iterations, some more changes, modifications later on. But the early date of filing, the priority date is very important. Okay. So this is very critical thing. publication. What do you mean a patent publication? See, I would like to take some time. Patent published, patent granted. So you will find some social media status like patent granted. Okay, but it's not possible. If somebody is filing for a patent, he or she should write patent published, okay, or pending. But granted is not possible. So this is a small what we say ignorance which people do. So publication is something else. The application which you have filed provisionally is automatically published after 1.5 years. So don't say or comment or write that the patent is published. Okay, then. But you need not to pay any fee till the patent is published. Okay, but if you are in a hurry, you can pay some nominal fee extra and you can request early publication. Okay, if it, suppose for faculties, if it is required in their this performance criteria, if it is required for their promotion, for a students, if they want to go abroad and want to have the patent under their belt, so they can opt for early publication. Okay, there's form 9 and you need to pay a small fee. Okay, fine. So early publication can be done. Now this is important. There's a timeline of 48 months. Okay, the date on which you are filed is priority date. After 12 months, it will be confirmed. After 18 months, it will be published. After 48 months, after 4 years, you will be called for examination. Okay, and they will not call you. An inventor, normally what happens, we students and faculties, we take it lightly. Once it is filed, you relax. So you need to record the date of filing, which is priority date. And after 4 years, you have to file the request for examination. Okay. And you need to pay nominal fee. After that, the examiner creates the first examination report. Okay. And then you will be given the grant, final grant. Right. So it's a long process. I will share once more. Now the response to objections. If there are some objections coming by examiner, you need to respond. Again, the patent attorney can do it in a proper manner. Okay. So once the objections are raised, within 1 year, you have to give response. Okay. So this is very much required. If there are no objections, well done. But if there are some objections, small ones even though, then you need to give your responses. Now, the inventor and the patent agent, they sit together, they create a response, and they again try to convince or prove the controller that yes, all the criteria are being met now, and these are the some comments which will help you in further verifying. Okay, then the patent is granted to you. Congratulations. And there will be a seal of patent office, the date of grant, and the priority date will be also given, right? So it's a wonderful process. So this is the grant of patent. Okay. So the application will be granted only, the patent will be granted only if it will be meeting all the patentability requirements. Okay. And as I said, it will be fully sealed from patent office, and there is a patent journal which is published by the government of India or any government, and your grant of patent will be notified. Just like PhD, if anybody is doing doctorate, PhD, it will be notified. Okay. Similarly, the grant of patent is also notified, right? Now, this is very important. Okay, and some people are very expert in that. So before the grant, there can be opposition from any person who can file an application that he is opposing on such and such points. Okay, and the wonder is there is no fee. Okay, and even if the grant is given to you on patent, within 1 year, any person can also file a position, right? So it's easy that you can file patent, but there are some hiccups also. Any person, okay, out of curiosity, out of some animosity, okay, they can file a position. And even if the patent is granted, for first 2 years, you need not to pay any fee. But thereafter, third year onwards, you need to pay a renewal fee, very nominal. So that's the meaning of the patent timeline. Okay, I will give you one more taste of that in coming slides. This is the timeline. We assume that all the details are ready with you. Your idea has been incubated and you are now ready to discuss with the patent agent. If you know any patent agent, or if your college has signed some MOU with any patent attorney or agency, then it's done. Otherwise, you need to have NDA, non-disclosure agreement, you should sign, because it's your property, your intellectual property. Before discussing with anybody else, forget sharing on social media, you need to have NDA signed, non-disclosure agreement. Keep in mind, I request that those who are interested, they should note it down. Even if the patent attorney is your known or referred by someone, you should sign NDA. Okay, after signing the non-disclosure agreement by you and the patent agent or attorney, within 10 to 15 days, maybe after mutual discussion face to face or on emails, you agree on final version of the draft. Okay, I agree. You will ask some questions, you need to give some input, some diagrams, some okay sketches. So it takes around 1 to 2 weeks. Then within 2 weeks, you can file in the government patent office. What? Provisional application. Okay. That will mark the beginning of your journey. And then you can write patent pending or patent apply. What's my point? You cannot say patent published. Okay, or patent granted is long way to go. Okay, then it takes two to three years for the grant of patent by normal route. Okay, but if you want expedited route, there are some extra charges. Okay, VIP route, it can be granted 1 year early. Okay, but even if you file the patent, you can carry on your work. Don't think that once the patent will be granted, then I will take this, commercialize this. You can start working on your commercializing things, marketing things, studying things. Okay, automatically, as per the flow, the patent will be granted. Okay, then obviously the cost. Okay, there are two broad categories. One, the government charges. Okay, in the form. Okay, form 9, form 16. Okay, some renewals, some changes. What happens, you file for three inventors, but you came to know, okay, one fourth was also there, but we forgot. So you can go for a request with nominal fee of 100 rupees, 200 rupees. You can include some name. Okay, so there is a government fee section, and there are some professional charges. If you're hiring some patent professional, so there are some professional charges, and the government fees are also different for an individual inventor or for a small company startup. Okay, I would like to show what are the different government fee. If you can see this, I don't know. So this is from the government office. You can see on the application, 1600 rupees. Okay, natural e-filing, physical filing. Okay, then all different sections are given on request for extension of time. Okay, you can expedite the patent process or you can ask for more time. Okay, then. But the best thing is to file as soon as possible. Then notice of opposition. Then all these are having some nominal fee. Okay, fine. And there are some sections also later on. So it depends on government fee. If you talk about the quantity, approximately anyone can incur 35,000 to 45,000 to file a patent. Okay, fine. And for startups under Startup India or for students, the cost is lowest. Okay, so the breakup would be like this: 15,000 to 35,000 or 25,000 based on the kind of technicalities involved. You need to pay attorney fee. Then provisional patent application throughout will be around 15,000. Then complete application will be 20,000. Then if you go directly, there will be a difference of 5 to 10,000. Okay. With patent attorney, it can be 35 to 40. Directly, if you are going, it can be 10,000 less, like that. But if you have that ability to draft a patent and you know the entire process, you can do it. Right. So the cost is there. In most of the cases, it is borne by institutes, okay, or applicant. Right? Now, very important question. I would like to take this in open session, but do I need a patent? Okay. Because it's okay. We are doing, we are publishing, we are okay presenting something here and there. So this patent for me also, can anyone file a patent? Yes. As I said, there is a cost, 35 to 45,000. So is it really worth investing? Okay. And normally people think that rather than going for patent, I will use that money in somewhere else. Okay. And even if I'm applying from the business point of view, will I get the return on investment? Is ROI there? In how much time I will cover the money invested? So those are small, small things. Okay. And the big question is, who will pay? For students, sometimes it is tough for them to pay other than their tuition fees and some hostel charges, food charges. If they are paying some amount for patent, so they may think. Similarly, faculties may also think, but there are some policies at place with good institutions like yours, like mine. We have the IP policy, we have the innovation policy, startup policy. So normally the organization, they share the load of, especially the cost part of filing. And you may ask any industry also to do that. Okay. But in that case, they will require some equity. Okay. But the answer is, already you are doing something for your idea, isn't it? You invested a lot of time, lot of energy. Then you may have skipped some lunches or dinners in working towards your idea. So if you're giving away all those things, intangible maybe, time, energy, so it is not suggestible that you throw it away. Once you have done so much of hard work, better it is to document and have patent on your name. Okay. One more reason is you can leverage it. Okay. Number one, other than name and fame, I have patents, two patents, three patents, three copyrights. So other than the name and fame and the promotion, you are given the exclusive rights, right? Nobody can use your invention for commercial purpose for at least 20 years. Okay. Then you can make significant return on the investment made. Okay. You can license to some industry. You can build some business around. Nowadays you will find, okay, even a water purifier, RO, patented technology. Even engine oil is having some patented technology. So you can gain more benefits out of your existing products by incorporating patented technology. Okay. So you can partially sell, you can completely sell, you can do your own business in and around that patent. Okay. And to all the students out there, once you have a patent for something, you can have more chances of getting the funding from investors, personal investors, institutional investors, from government schemes. So the patent helps a lot. Okay, fine. And if you are holding a patent in some technology or invention, general idea would be to, what will be the general idea? That, okay, he is the expert in that domain. Like your PhD, like your patent, both are actually highlighting that you are master of that subject, you are expert of that subject, what we say subject matter expert. So you know about PhDs. Now the patents are also, PhD doctorate is also having some commercial aspect that you will be given a promotion, but that's limited. But by licensing, cross licensing your patent, you can reap much, much higher benefits. Believe me, you can't imagine also. Okay. In a nutshell, you can sell it, or the investors will start coming to you because you have the intellectual property. Okay. Everybody has got mind, everybody has got brain, everybody has got degree, but this will be your intellectual property, and that will attract investors. Okay, right? Now, to young guys there, there is something called changing nature of work. If you can see the graph very clearly, in 1969 and now in 1999, okay, fine. So this is not very latest, but you can see earlier there were routine jobs, non-routine jobs, some manuals. Then now the topmost red line is expert thinking. This is the era where expert thinkings are being demanded. And what better than holding a patent that will automatically give you the leverage of being an expert to mint money around it. Okay. So the expert thinking domain is working, and slowly India is also catching up. And many of you might be knowing that we are now at rank 46th, okay, on Global Innovation Index, recently published 2021 ranking. And small countries like Switzerland, Sweden, US, UK and Korea are top 5. And this will happen only when not only we work on idea, we innovate, but we file patent also. Okay. So how many patents are filed in an institution? How many patents are filed in a country? Okay. So those are also very, very critical factors. Okay. So you can leverage on, and you can see science and engineering graduates are India's strengths. It is being forecasted. So all young people out there, graduates, science, engineering, commerce, whatever. So you can leverage the intellectual property by investing small amount that too can be shared or waived off, and have that patent which will mark you as subject matter expert. Investors will come running to you, not means directly running, but they will be more tempted. Third name and fame is there. So there is no doubt that why one should not file a patent. Okay. Now with this, so I've given some time, but I kept this for open forum. If anybody is having any doubt whatsoever, he or she can ask. I request Ms. Pragati, Dr. Sheetal ma'am. If there are some queries on the chat box, if there are some queries, okay, on your WhatsApp, you can please let me know.
Yes, sir. We have few questions lined up. So may I please?
Please.
So somebody is there who wants to know that why is it required to have patent attorney?
Okay. Fine. It's a good question, and I hope that I have answered. See, it's your wish. You keep on inventing, do not file a patent. But as I said, all your hard work, okay, it's going in vain. So even if you don't want to commercialize it, at least you can document it for two reasons. Number one, it helps you also for further reference. And secondly, based on your documented work, which is a patent, others may also gain insights. Okay, fine. So it's always a good idea that you search some patents. You Google out so many things, the spellings, the latest trends, fashions and everything. So you can Google out the patents also. So your work will not be in your room, your college, it will be in public domain, but with exclusive right given to you. So you should file a patent at any cost, provided it is patentable. So there is no doubt about that.
Thank you so much, sir. And the next question we have is, when is the best time to protect one's property?
Pardon me, please repeat.
When is the best time to protect one's property?
One profit?
Profit, property.
Okay, fine.
What the idea which they are giving, yes.
Right. See, the best time is as soon as possible. Once you are clear that this idea is profitable, I perhaps must have emphasized a couple of times, 4 or 5 times, the early filing date, the priority date is very, very important. So you should file the provisional application as soon as possible, because that only will give you cutting edge. The patent will be published or not, whether your invention is rejected, your proposal, that's the secondary thing. But if you're sure a little bit, you can file, you should file as soon as possible.
Thank you so much, sir. Thanks a lot. Thank you for sharing your work.
Sir Pragati, kindly announce the students, like if they want to raise a question.
Sure.
They may.
Okay. So it's a humble request. If you guys have any questions or queries to ask, kindly raise your hands.
So right now we have disabled the chat section for chats for the students. Anybody raising hand will enable it for all of them.
I would again like to request that if there is someone who wants to put and ask questions, kindly raise your hands.
Still, I will share this slide to Dr. Sheetal so that you can refer later on. So if there are no doubts, I am happy. But if there are no doubts, I am also apprehensive that... It's clear.
Yeah, one question from my side, sir. Yes. This is Dr. Sheetal. So, like you have mentioned that you should have the patents published in various countries. So, what, like you have mentioned the process in India, you know, which other countries one should target? Like, if you are filing for India, then which other countries, you know, which we can suitably target for?
Right. It's a very nice question, ma'am. Actually, it will depend on your this patent. Suppose you are working on some sustainable technology. So the advanced countries, the countries where there is a shortage of such things. So you can consult with your patent attorney and you can file at those places. Normally, when it comes to high technology things like some mobile development and some satellite things, so people used to file with in the countries like US and China mostly, because that will give you more chances of restricting the use there. But if you are working on sustainable technology, you can file in Netherlands, you can file in Sweden, because they work a lot on those technologies. And once you are decided that we need to file internationally, so your product, other countries domain, and your patent attorney, these four things will, along with you, the four things will be needed to get an answer, because filing at all locations will be costly affair.
Right, sir. Like if you are filing for process-based patents,
right?
So it's about, like you said, that sustainable technology patents can be filed in such kind of countries. But if you are filing for process-based patents, so is it necessary to have multiple countries, or if we can restrict ourselves to one nation like India only?
No, for process also similar things apply, because suppose you have designed a new process through which the solar panels can give you more output. So that process you have developed, you are not developing a product. So you can give to some other companies internationally. So suppose you want to go to Egypt, for example, where lots of solar panels are being used and you are wishing to that their government or the companies there must use your process. So then you can file there and then ask them. Or in that case, they will ask also you, that okay, we want to collaborate with you, but in our country, please file the patent with we as co-applicant, or we'll pay the charges, then we'll take on commercial aspect. Sometimes they also will come forward because they also want that with your technology, they should be given the exclusive rights.
So what, like one student is writing to me asking that what is the patent filing process in Australia? Sir, if you could enlighten us.
I don't know.
Okay. Any other country, I think, you know, would do.
It's similar because the Indian government is also very fast. So the process is almost similar. The sections might be somewhere here. The entire six to eight steps you have to take and you can do it. You can go for early publication. You can request more time. So all things are same because you cannot work in silos. Our government or Indians cannot be very slow and Australians cannot be very fast. So there is a World Intellectual Property Organization, WIPO, which governs all the processes in all the countries. So I can say 90% similar.
Right. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you, ma'am.
Ma'am, you must have IT who like is speaking here.
Okay. All right, sir. Pragati, please continue.
Sure, ma'am. Thank you so much, sir, for sharing your words of wisdom with us. It was
I'm sorry, I'm stopping you. Those enthusiastic students out there, my dear colleagues, faculties out there, I strongly suggest that even if you are filing a patent or not, it's secondary, but at least you should go through this database because you never know which thing will click you and you can start working on it and have patents or number of patents. So there is a WIPO patent scope in India. TIFAC has developed ECUSV, which is the first Indian patent database. Then you have Canadian, European, and very, very common Google patents. Just like Google Scholar for researchers, you have Google patents. So definitely go for this so that you can get more idea about how the patents are being drafted. Okay, fine. Thank you so much.
Yes, sir. Thank you, sir. It was really enlightening and appreciable how with such ease you would throw enough light on patent and relevant aspects. And you let us know that how it is important and should be known to a common man. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much, Ms. Pragati. Once again, big thank to Dr. Sheetal ma'am for having me here. Have a nice day and stay happy and healthy. Thank you so much.
Yes, sir. Before you leave, most welcome, sir. It was really, really a pleasure having you here. And we have really learned a lot. Thank you so much, sir.
Thank you so much. Please allow me to leave now. Thank you.
Yes, sir. Yes. So, Pragati, kindly make that announcement that the session is going to begin at 1:30. So,
now I would like to request everybody that kindly rejoin the link on 1:30. We are having another guest with us. So please join the link and be there with us. Thank you so much.
Yeah, so before everybody leave, one very important announcement. The students, if you want to take the certificates, you have to fill the feedback form as well. We have posted it in through the chat section also in the webinar channel itself. Also, we are circulating it through your class group. So kindly fill it up. And the students from BBA may not join again at 1:30. They may resume their classes. Although this webinar is open for all the voluntary participants, but if they have their classes, they want to go for their classes, they can do that. MBA students, they need to join this session at 1:30 sharp. Right? Thank you so much. We'll see you again at 1:30.
Gaurav Chandal, who wants to ask something, he's raising hands. Sir is there.
Okay. Let it be then, yes.
Okay, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, please.
Okay, sir. So you're there, right? You want to ask a question?
You can ask.
You can.
Hello, sir. This is Dr. Gaurav Jindal.
Yes, sir.
My question is that like we can file Australian patent also and Indian patent also, but as far as like our teaching and learning concepts are teaching fraternity is concerned, how different it is to file a patent in Indian government or with Australian government? Does it make any difference, or it is the same, sir?
Okay. It's a very nice and pertinent question, actually. Sir, actually, it's mindset. It's like sher ke muh mein khoon lagna. So teaching fraternity, if you say, myself included, so we are normally, I should not say burdened, but we are busy with so many things, routine work and some academic, non-academic reporting things. But if you have a group of good students under your mentoring, with your guidance and everything, they will come up with idea, and maybe some colleagues working together, they can develop. So it's a one-time thing, and once you have that taste, I should say, then the entire filing process is very easy. Believe me, sir, it's very easy. If you have a good patent attorney like I have, all the things are done. You need to supply the data only, and they will do the rest of the process, and the entire process is transparent. So no fear, nothing. It's the matter of start.
Right, sir. Right. Thank you, sir.
Welcome, sir. Thank you. Please allow me now, Sheetal ma'am, Ms. Pragati.
Sure, sir. Yes, we are honored. Thank you once again.
Are there any more questions, or if you permit, I can leave?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
No more.
Yes, right, sir. So students, you can also leave, join back at 1:30.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much, sir.